Now we have to talk about housing your chickens. Now, not everyone wants to build a permanent structure, and in some cases, free ranging is not an option either. You may live on a smaller plot, and you may have neighbors nearby that wouldn't appreciate chickens rooting through their gardens and scratching up their plants. One of the solutions for something like that is to build a portable chicken coop. This portable coop has an open floor and allows you to move the chickens to specific areas. It's complete with a nesting box and a place for the chickens to sleep at night. So let's go over some of the features of a portable coop. Keep in mind there's an infinite number of varieties that are available. You can buy them prefabricated through mail order, or you can design and build your own, like this one here. It was just of my own design, and it's heavy enough to withstand heavy winds, but light enough that you can actually move it around. Children, of course, wouldn't be able to move it by themselves, but a single adult could feasibly do it. When it comes to building your own portable chicken coop, try not to get too fancy. Keep it basic and keep it fairly lightweight. If you get carried away and build too many amenities onto the coop, you'll end up with something so heavy that you just can't move it around. It's a great way to till a garden as well, and I recommend a book that's called The Chicken Tractor, which talks about portable coops, portable pens, and using them to tend the soil that you're going to garden in later. Let's go over some of the features of this portable coop. Remember, when you're designing your portable coop or even a permanent coop, make the dimensions suitable for an adult to access everything that you're going to have to do in the coop. If you make it too small, you'll be bent over all the time, and you'll have to carry maybe a 50-pound bag of feed in to fill feeders, and you'll also be hauling water in and out. So consider that when you're thinking about the dimensions of your coop. This particular one is 6 feet tall, it's 7 feet long, and it's only 3 feet wide. I limited the width of the coop to 3 feet because the extensions of these middle bars are actually the handles that we use to lift it and roll it to a new location after every few days. The door is an easy screen door. You just turn the wood, pull it open, and then let's go over some of the features inside. Having a portable coop with an open bottom is so much better than just having a penned in area that your chickens use each and every day. The portable coop will not allow the chickens to wear out the soil underneath or to eat all the grass and defoliate that area. Soil that's constantly tread upon by chickens and constantly contributed to with their waste material becomes toxic over time, and you either have to rotate your chickens to a new paddock or make a new pen altogether. A portable chicken coop allows you to continually move your entire chicken coop, their nest box, and all their resources with them, so you never wear out the soil, and your chickens don't free range, so they're not going to bother your neighbors or your pets, and they also will be protected from things like stray dogs and cats as they grow. This coop is designed dimensionally really to accommodate only bantam chickens. Standard full-size chickens may need a larger habitat than this. So this one is for about 5 bantams, 1 rooster, and 4 hens. Now, the portable coop like this, although it is completely enclosed except for the bottom so that your chickens can scratch the soil and eat bugs and eat greens, the enclosure does not really protect them from predators at night. Weasels and smaller predators could actually come through different openings in this. So just like a regular chicken coop, they need to have a secure location for the night. And this nest box area here, which is also their perch and roosting area, provides them protection through the night. So if a predator got through this screen or wire wall, or even came underneath the coop at night, your chickens will still be safe inside, and you should close it just as you would any other chicken coop to protect them. They have a ramp that goes all the way down, and it's secured at both ends to the coop itself so it doesn't rest on the ground, so when you move it, it all moves together, and your chickens can freely go in and out of this coop box during the day. When you're introducing your chickens to the coop that they're going to stay in, whether it's portable like this one or if it's a permanent coop, always start the chickens inside. Don't just turn them loose out here, expect them to find the hole and consider this home. By starting them inside and keeping them inside overnight, then they know that this is their home. By suspending your feeder and drinker from a chain, you're also making sure that they hang level, no matter what the surface is that you're going to park your portable coop on. When the chickens go to bed at night, you want to elevate the feeder and keep it up and out of the way. So with a chain and a hook, all you have to do is pull the drinker and the feeder up and hook it in the overhead underneath the nest box. This way it's out of the way of predators, mice, and other things that will run around at night, and try to take advantage of the feed that your chickens have and that they may spill on the ground. It's smart each day or every couple of days to move the portable coop to brand new soil so things don't have a chance to get rancid. As you can see, the side on this portable coop is hinged so that it can be swung open, and you'll have access as a coop tender to the inside of this nesting box, which is also where the chickens roost at night. Now, when you're having a box like this, you need to think about it in terms of how are you going to clean it later. So make sure that perches, and in this case the perches are just set in place, make sure that they're removable so that you can clean out the substrate here. I like to litter raise my chickens, so there is no droppings pit. We just put wood shavings in and let it stay there until it mixes up with the chicken waste. Then, of course, we put that in the garden. So you can see also that there's a nest box inside, and this is sized for a bantam. This next box is 12 inches by 12 inches by 14 inches high. And it has a slanted roof, so you could also take it out, put it on the grass, and leave it outside if the weather's warm. And this is the inside view showing the pop hole for the chicken. Now let's say you want to provide some additional perches inside your portable coop during the day, and you want to make it easy to pull them out when you're going to service the coop. All you have to do is take pieces of 1x2 wood, round off the top so that it's nice for perching on for the bird's feet, and because it's also 1x2 cage wire here, we just slide it through the openings. And because this coop is 3 feet wide, we only have to make the perches 4 feet wide. Bits of the perch stick out on either side, and then you just take a regular spike that you can get at the hardware store and slide it through a hole that you drill, and that will keep it from pulling through and falling down on the birds when they're inside. Then when you need to service the coop, you just pull the spikes out, which draw the perch, and now you have free access. Plus, you can clean and sanitize these perches when you're doing the rest of the coop. And when the removable perches are not being used, I simply store them in the overhead on the coop itself, and that keeps them with me. Anytime I want to change them and move them back down, I just pull them out, drop the spikes in, and set them at whatever height I feel is necessary for the birds that are staying in the coop. Now these wheels are located at just one end of the coop, so we lift the whole thing up and move it like a wheelbarrow. My personal preference is not to use pneumatic or airfield tires, but rather use the solid rubber tires. Inevitably, when you go to use airfield tires, one will be flat, and then you've got a problem. So these are solid rubber tires, and they're just run through 2x4s that extend the entire length of the chicken coop. The 2x4s, again, are 8 feet long at the bottom, but the coop itself is only 7 feet long, 3 feet wide, and 6 feet tall. The chicken access ramp to the door is secured with nails and glue at the top, and then we follow it all the way down. It goes to the lead board, which is also the bottom of the doorway that people walk through. So no part of it rests on the ground. And this is how the portable coop looks from the end where the wheels are located. You can see that we have a window at the top of this 3 foot by 3 foot by 3 foot box. And also you can see how the roof looks. It's 3/8 inch thick material, and it's arched 4 feet by 8 feet long, and it just covers the coop from one end to the other, and the rest is 2x4 material and then 1x10s at each end, which gives it some kind of structural support. The entire thing is finished with exterior wood stain. Before we talk about the design elements of a chicken coop, let's talk about where you're going to locate it. Putting a chicken coop, for example, right next to the woods or in a heavily wooded or treed area like this is pretty much a bad idea. So if you had the option of putting it out in the open, I recommend that. Predators inhabit the woods and hunt the perimeter of the woods frequently. So if you put a chicken coop there, you're actually ringing the dinner bell for wildlife.